C2 Transfer is a secure file transfer solution that protects your files with end-to-end encryption. For each transfer task, you'll share a link with your recipients to access your files. They must enter a one-time password for identity verification before they can download the files. Also, you can set a link expiration date, free up storage space by having the files automatically deleted after the task expires, and even add watermarks to files to enhance data security. C2 Transfer provides three plans: free, professional, and business. Whether you're a solo user or a business of any size, there's a plan designed just for you. For more details on pricing and features, check out the link in the description. In this video, you'll learn how to configure file transfer settings and set up a transfer policy, a feature exclusive to our business plan users. First, click Add Files and choose to upload from your device or C2 Transfer storage. You can also upload files or folders by dragging and dropping them directly. Once your upload is done, you can set up files transfer settings. Click the gear icon to customize the settings. Give your transfer task a name and set how long you'd like the link to be valid. Just remember, once the link expires, the recipients won't be able to access the content anymore. You can set a restriction where a file can only be downloaded once. After the file is downloaded, it will no longer be available for anyone to access. You can also enable automatic file deletion to save space. This means that all files added to this task will be permanently deleted from storage when the task expires. Finally, choose whether to add a watermark to your files. C2 Transfer currently supports PDF, JPEG, PNG, and JPG formats. One option is a text watermark. Feel free to type anything you like or use the visitor contact variable, which will show the recipient's email or phone number. You can also go with an image watermark. Just make sure the image is in JPG, JPEG, or PNG format. Here, we'll select a text watermark and click Save to complete the settings. Double-check that everything's set up, then click Next. Now, let's configure who can access your task files. You can choose to limit access to specific recipients. If you'd like to do that, simply enter the recipient's mobile phone number or email. If you're on the professional or business plan, you'll see another option that allows anyone with the link to access the link. For security, they'll still need to verify via email or mobile phone before accessing the files. If you choose to verify recipients via email, you can set up a block list to prevent specific email addresses or domains from accessing files. Once you're ready, go on and create your link. Once the link is created, copy its URL or QR code to share with your recipients. You can also send the link via email or any other method that works best for you. Once a recipient opens the link, they'll be asked to enter their email. After that, they'll receive an email for identity verification. They can either enter the one-time password or click Verify Email from the email to download the files. Once the recipient finishes the download, you'll get a notification email from the system. Click View in C2 Transfer, and you can see a record of their access. If you're the administrator of a C2 Transfer business plan, you can set the transfer policy that applies rules to all tasks, including task names, watermarks, and security settings. Let's explore them one by one. First, go to Management. Transfer policy, and select apply a naming rule to all user tasks. This means that everyone's tasks will follow the same naming rule. Go ahead and enter the task name you prefer. Here, we'll use Synology underscore as an example. You can also add different variables to the name, such as the username or display name of the user creating the task. In this example, we'll use the timestamp. Take a look below to preview the naming rule. The specified task name, Synology underscore, and the timestamp variable showing the time when the task is created. Next, you can select Allow users to add custom text on the end of the specified name. In this way, when your users create tasks, they can add custom text after the name you specify. In the Watermark section, you can configure watermark settings for all transfer tasks. For example, you can allow users to apply customized watermarks or apply a default watermark for everyone. Moving on to the Security section, you can choose whether users can make their tasks accessible to everyone or restrict recipients to a single download once they receive the link. You can also set a maximum link expiration period of up to 365 days for your users. After you're all done, click Save. Finally, let's take a look at the Access Restrictions tab. Here, you can set up an allowed list or block list. Just enter an email address or domain, and it will apply to all transfer tasks by default. Once you're done, simply click Save. To learn more about C2 Transfer, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel or click on another video to keep watching.